modes of heat transfer. Heat flows from a hot object to a cold object, or heat flows from an object at the higher temperature to another object which is at a lower temperature. This flow of heat is known as the transfer of heat. Example, if you dip a steel spoon into the cup of hot tea, then we will find that the temperature of the spoon rises and becomes hot. In this case, some of the heat contained in hot tea has been transferred to spoon which is placed inside it. When the two objects attain the same temperature, then the flow of heat stops. And this means that no heat will be transferred from one object to another. If the temperature of the two objects is the same, there are three ways through which heat can be transferred from a hot object to a cold object. First one, by conduction, which is in solid, heat is transferred by conduction. Second, by convection, which is takes place in liquid and gases, and heat is transferred by convection. And the third, the last one, by radiation. In free spaces or vacuum, heat is transferred by radiation. Let us discuss all the three ways of heat transfer one by one. First one, conduction, the mode of transfer of heat from the hotter part of a material to its colder part, or from a hot material to a cold material in contact with it. Without the movement of material as a whole is known as conduction. In all the solid, heat is transferred by the process of conduction. In the process of conduction, there is no actual movement of the particles or materials as a whole, and the heat is transferred by the vibration of the particle. The vibrating particles vibrate back and forth and transfer the heat to the neighboring particles. And this continues till both objects acquire same temperature. Therefore, the transfer of heat by conduction can happen only through solids. Materials which allow heat to be conduct through them easily are the conductor of heat, and those metals such as iron, copper, silver, aluminium, etc. are the good conductor of heat. Bad conductor of heat are those materials which do not allow heat to be conducted through them easily. These materials are also known as insulator of heat. For example, wood, plastic and glasses are the insulators of heat. What are the uses of that to good and bad conductor of heat? During the winter season, we generally wear woolen clothes. If we compare them with the cotton clothes, then we will find that the wool fibers have much more spaces between them. These get filled with air, which is a bad conductor of heat. Hence, being an insulator, both wool and air together prevent the heat from our bodies from escaping out. Also, jute and the sawdust are bad conductor of heat. We cover the eyes with a jute cloth of sawdust to prevent it from gaining heat from the surrounding and then melting. The next is the applications of conductor and that insulator. First one, cooking utensils. Cooking utensils are made up of a good conductor so that they are allowed to flow of heat to cook inside, while the handles of the utensils are made up of insulators so has to hold the utensils easily. Second, building materials. Houses are built using insulating materials such as bricks, mud, sheets, etc. so that the heat should not be conducted from outside to inside during summer and from inside to outside during winter. And the third one, clothes. The clothes that we wear in winters are generally woolen, because wool is an insulating material. Thus, woolen clothes do not allow our body to lose heat to the surrounding and keep us warm. Also, air is an insulator, and hence the air trapped in the tiny holes of the woolen clothes also does not allow any heat loss from our body to the surrounding. Good conductor and bad conductor of heat. For example, during winter season, a metal object keep in a room feel very cold to touch, but a wooden object in the same room feel warmer to touch. Metal object is a good conductor of heat, so when we touch the metal object, it conducts away heat from our hand quickly, and by losing heat, our hand feels cold. On the other side, the wooden object, being a poor conductor of heat, does not allow the heat of our hand to escape and hence feels warmer to touch. The water or most liquids and the air or gases are bad conductor of heat. Next one is that the second one, convection. The mode of transfer of heat from the hotter part of a fluid to its colder parts of the movement of the liquid itself is known as convection, and the transfer of heat by the convection can take place only in liquid and gases. It is due to the reason that the particles in liquid and gases can move about freely. So the transfer of heat by convection cannot take place in solid because the particles in the solids are fixed at a place and cannot move about freely. It is also not occurred in empty space or vacuum because there are no particles of any kinds in empty space which can move and transfer heat. Have you ever seen a parachute move upward into the sky? It is because hot air causes it to rise upward and it becomes warmer and lighter than the rest of the environment. Heat gets transferred from the flame to the air above it and hence it rises. This is due to the convectional properties of heat. Applications of convection. Before moving that application of convection, we know that how the convection takes place in water, air and some other substance. For example, the convection in water. Water is a poor conductor of heat, so due to this reason, it cannot transfer heat by conduction, but it transfers heat by the process of convection. Second, the convection in air. Air is a very poor conductor of heat, and air transfers heat from its hotter part to the colder part by the process of convection. Next, sea and land breeze. The blowing of sea breeze and the land breeze in coastal areas in generally occur due to the convection of heat in air. In coastal areas during the daytime, the breeze generally flows from the sea towards the land and during the night times blow from the land towards the sea. Sea and land breeze are actually convection of heat. During the day, the land heat up more than water. Due to this, the air over the land becomes hotter and lighter and rises up. So the air from the sea, which is colder and heavier, rushes to take the place created by hot rising air. Therefore, a sea breeze blows during the day. During the night, the land loses heat faster than water and becomes colder, and the air over the sea is now warmer, due to which it rises up and the colder airs over the land rushes to take its place. Therefore, we observe a land breeze at night. Radiation, the mode of transfer of heat through which heat energy from a hot body to a cold body by means of heat rays without any material medium between them is known as radiation. For example, the sun's heat reaches the earth by the process of radiation. The sun is very far away from the earth and there is mainly an empty space, that is vacuum, between the sun and the earth. Even then, the heat from the sun reaches the earth. This is due to the fact that the sun, being extremely hot, emits invisible heat radiation or infrared rays in all directions. This radiation travels through the vacuum between the sun and the earth at a very high speed and ultimately reaches on the earth. Therefore, we can say that the transfer of heat from a hot object to a cold object by the process of radiation does not require any medium. In our daily life activities, we have many situations where heat is transferred by the radiation through air. For example, depending on the temperature of the surrounding, our body too gives heat to the surrounding or receive heat from the surrounding by radiation. Second, if a hot utensil filled with hot milk is kept away from the flame, then it cools down by transferring its heat to the surrounding by radiation. And the third, if we stand next to the burning fire, then we feel that the heat of the fire falling on our face. The heat is transferred from the fire to our face by the process of radiation. Next, the applications of radiation. Solar cooker. The solar cooker makes use of heat radiation from the sun, and the boxes of solar cooker is painted black from inside so that it absorbs maximum heat radiation coming from the sun. Second, solar panels. Solar panels are designed to trap maximum solar energy to perform various activities such as heating, water, cooking, lighting, street, etc. Then in solar panels, a black metal sheet is used to increase the absorption of heat from the sun's rays. Properties of heat. Heat manifests itself into substance and has the different effect on different materials. Other than that, it has a few properties of its own. First one, increase in temperature. When a substance is heated, it causes a rise in the temperature of that body. For example, when water is heated, it becomes warmer. If one prolongs the heating, the water increases in volume and expands. Second one, the changes in state. The degree of heat gives a body determines how its state changes. If one boils water in a vessel, it will change into steam. Sometimes these properties of heat causes problems in real life. During summer, iron railways tracks expand due to heat and cause derailing of trains. In order to avoid accident, a little space is left between two tracks when they are late, otherwise they bend. Third one, change in chemical composition. Heat brings about a change in the chemical composition of a substance. When calcium carbonate is heated, it decomposes into calcium oxide and carbon dioxide. By adding heat, a solid substance decomposes into a mercury, while a white substance in a heated temperature and gas. Then next, effect on living organism. You must have seen your mother giving your boy water to drink when you contract fever. It is because heated water kills the bacteria and disease causing microorganisms, and also the organism can only survive within the specific range of temperature.